Hello students, this is K.V. Ramana, lecturer of Zoology. In the last lecture, we have completed about the mechanism of breathing and what is a breathing and what are the steps involved in the breathing, we have completed. Today, the continuity of this episode 30, we are going to talk about forceful expiration. What do you mean by expiration, first of all? There are two important steps involved in the breathing. One is inspiration, second is expiration. Inspiration means inhalation of air. That means the atmospheric air is enters into the lungs. That is the process we can call as a inspiration. Expiration means expulsion of air from the lungs to atmosphere. Right? So these two steps together we call breathing. So in the last episode 12, we learnt about mechanism of breathing, in that what steps involved in the process of mechanism breathing also we have completed, that is the inspiratory process and expiratory process. During normal breathing there are two important muscles are involved. One is diaphragm, second one is external intercostal muscles. Let us see, in today's class we are going to talk about the forceful expiration. As a human being, as a mammals, they have ability to take the more air. Right? So before taking the more air, we should empty the lungs first of all. Generally, lungs do not empty. Some amount of air will be remaining in the lungs. Even though forceful expiration, that we can call as a residual volume of air. But during, you want to strengthen the expiration, at that time what happens, you know, what is the air will be in the lungs, that will be expelled out. Right? That we can call as a forceful expiration. I told you what is the need of forceful expiration. Whenever you want to increase the forceful inspiration, immediately you should be empty it. What is the air will be remaining in the lungs. Except that residual volume of air, remaining air you can be expel out by the forceful expiration. Right? So let me explain about today's class, that is about the forceful expiration. So this forceful expiration, when it is required, we have ability to increase our strength of expiration. When you want to expel more air, when you want to go for the exercises or vigorous activities or any strengthened exercises, at the time what happens, you know, we need more amount of air. At that time we have ability to expel more amount of air, right? So at that time, which muscles are involved? There are two important muscles are involved during the forceful expiration. One is internal intercostal muscles. Another one is abdominal muscles. If you see the picture, you can understand where the internal intercostal muscles and abdominal muscles are present, right? Let me explain first of all about the internal intercostal muscles. Here, internal intercostal muscles and abdominal muscles are functioning same. In the last previous lecture, we have completed about the location of the internal intercostal muscles. Basically, intercostal muscles are two types. One is external intercostal muscles, second one is internal intercostal muscles. External intercostal muscles and internal intercostal muscles both are present in between the ribs. Right? I think you have understood. To know about more information regarding the internal intercostal muscles, just watch the previous video. You will get the idea. Right? Next, come to the abdominal muscles. Generally, abdominal muscles are the muscles which are present between the visceral organs, which are present in the abdominal cavity and diaphragm. That means diaphragm and visceral organs are connected by the abdominal muscles. These abdominal muscles and internal intercostal muscles are involved in the forceful breathing, right? But both functions are same. Both functions are same. These two are helps to strengthen the expiration. That means both are involved in the forceful expiration. You very very careful about this, right? During the normal breathing, external intercostal muscles and diaphragm is involved, right? During the forceful expiration or forceful breathing, one is the internal intercostal muscles and abdominal muscles are involved, right? Let me explain about the internal intercostal muscles. Generally, internal intercostal muscles are present between the ribs, right? When it is contraction, right? During contraction of these internal intercostal muscles, it leads to pulling of ribs downward and inward. Very, very important. Downward and inward, right? During the normal expiration, what happens? The external intercostal muscles are contracted more forward and upward. But during the contraction of internal intercostal muscles are, what happened? Pulling the ribs inward Okay, now downward and inward. That means what is the ribs are present? That ribs are moves inward and downward. By this, what happens? You know, that means it leads to the volume of thoracic cavity decreases. When the internal intercostal muscles are contracted, the ribs moves inward and downward. Inward and downward. That means it is going inside and downward. By that, it applies the pressure on the chest cavity. By that, what happens now? The volume of thoracic cavity decreases. The volume of thoracic cavity decreases. It means the volume of pulmonary cavity also decreases. That means lungs are present in the thoracic cavity. Pulmonary cavity is nothing but the cavity present inside the lungs. Thoracic cavity is nothing but the cavity present inside the chest or thoracic region of the body, right? Next, by the result of these volumes, whenever the volumes are decreases, immediately pressure will be increases. You know the Boyle's law. The Boyle's law explains what is that. Okay, now volume is inversely proportional to pressure. Volume is inversely proportional to pressure. That means whenever the volume is decreases, automatically pressure will be increases. So the pressure increases in the pulmonary cavity. Then whenever the pressure is increased in the pulmonary cavity, the air moves from its high pressure to its low pressure, right? So compared with the atmospheric pressure within the lungs, our intrapulmonary pressure will be more, so that the air moves from the its high pressure to its low pressure. That is nothing but expulsion of air from the its high pressure, that is in the lungs, to its low pressure, that is into the atmosphere. ATM represents the atmosphere, right? So this is about the internal intercostal muscles. Second one is abdominal muscles. Abdominal muscles also, when these muscles are contracts, comprises the abdomen and pushes to, sorry, what we have seen in the internal intercostal muscles, same process occur in the, where it is in the abdominal muscles. So these two muscles are play a very important role in forceful expiration, right? The main difference between normal breathing and forceful breathing is, normal breathing is depends on external intercostal muscles and diaphragm, right? And forceful breathing is depends on the internal intercostal muscles and abdominal muscles, right? Internal intercostal muscles and abdominal muscles, right? Let us see what is the summarization of action of diaphragm, the action of external intercostal muscles, the action of internal intercostal muscles, and the action of abdominal muscles. Very, very important. One of the questions will come in the NEET examination in this area, right? Thank you.